So what's going on, guys? Mr. Dalek JD here, and welcome to the video you guys have been waiting for. Some early gameplay of the brand new Exo Zombies Infection map. It's going to be 10 minutes of early gameplay footage for you guys to give you a little look at the map, get you a brief feel for things when you get the map on Tuesday in the Advanced Warfare Ascendants DLC. Guys, if you enjoyed this video, be sure to smash that like button down below. Let's go for 3,000 likes, and make sure to share this video with your friends if you are excited for the new Exo Zombies map. So this is Infection. This is the starting room. We have two options to go through, just like with the first map. This is kind of the warehouse area that you may have seen from the early preview pictures of this map. But this map is, as promised, a lot bigger, a bit of a complicated layout in terms of in comparison to the first map. But there's a lot of interesting things they've added into this, and a few new changes which you guys are going to be interested in. So as you can see on screen, the original four characters have returned, and I won't explain how they've managed to survive into the second map, but I'll have an upload of the cutscene when the map comes out, and by the time you're watching this it may even be out, so make sure to check my channel for that. And there'll also be some more gameplay showing you guys the new microwave gun. So this is going to be where the box will spawn every single time. The 3D printer will always be in this location, and we have all the weapons that we had from the first map, but we have the additional microwave gun. So like I mentioned, the map is a lot bigger. We have a lot of more open spaces, but it's actually a little bit trickier than the first map. Maybe it's just getting used to the map, but there's a lot of open areas where you can easily train these zombies, jump up onto the buildings and get some high ground, so then you can slam down onto them. Now, like I mentioned, this map is bigger than the first map. Rather than there just be one single like level, there is high ground areas and there is low ground areas, which are the sewer systems, which we'll get into shortly. But a massive focus on this map is that there are a lot of traps, rather than the first map, which had a few traps and we had those security drops which enabled all the traps at once. This actually has a load of traps, pretty much traps in every single room, more or less. And this is leading down into the underground sewer systems. And this is where you'll find the infection pad. So if you get infected, the pad will be somewhere down here. And also down here is the alligator drop. Funnily enough, it's a trap which is called the instigator. What will happen with that, if is there any zombies around, this random alligator will jump out of the water and will literally eat up all the zombies. Now, as you see on screen there, it says survivor located, and this is the civilian extraction. What you have to do is you have to find the survivor on the map. He will enter the map, and you have to escort him to a certain area. With this area, we had this flare on top of this platform in the spawn room, so we had to protect this character from the zombies whilst the evac chopper made its way to this location. When it eventually does arrive, it will take up the survivor, and then you will have done that and you'll be rewarded for it. Normally when you do this, you get rewarded with a free upgrade to your gun at the end of the round, which is pretty awesome in itself, just for a little small objective which doesn't take too long. But if you don't complete the survivor objective, you'll actually get penalized. And this introduced one of the new drops in the game, which is like a power drain. So what will happen is everything on the map that uses power, so perks, mystery box or 3D prints, stuff like that, will be disabled for around about 30 seconds. So it's pretty important to actually complete these civilian extraction objectives. Otherwise, you're going to get penalized, and that is not fun. Now, the underground sewer system leads you to another side of the map, which is from the spawn area, and then there is another option which takes you to the infamous Burger Town. This is what the whole map is based around, and it's an absolutely awesome little area to be in. As you can see, the Burger Town restaurant is absolutely destroyed. We have the mascot Bobby just being demonic, just standing there, and we have the massive burger which you can actually climb into. Not too sure how, but there is a ladder which will take you up through the burger, which is pretty insane. Now, we haven't spoken much about the new zombie types that are in this. So just like the normal Exo Zombies in the first map, we have the infected rounds where you have to decontaminate yourself if you get infected. Of course, this happens just as frequently as it did in the first map, nothing really different in that aspect. But we do have the addition of a few new zombie types, this being the acid drippers, the zombies with the weird spikes on them, and of course the Goliath Exo Zombie. Now, something important to note, which you guys may not realize, is that later on to the rounds, you'll have rounds with zombies and dogs. Normally it's always just been the dogs as their own separate round, but I guess kind of like throwing back to Dereese from World at War, eventually there'll be dogs in the zombie rounds as well, so that's something to watch out for. But these acid drippers, they look pretty similar to normal zombies, but you can see acid dripping out from them, and if you stand in those areas, obviously you're going to get hurt by that acid. And then we have the spike zombies, which aren't too different from the normal zombies. I didn't notice any difference from my short time getting to play this, but the Goliath exo-zombie, oh my goodness, this thing takes an insane amount of health. It is literally insane. If you get near it and it hits you, not only do you get damaged a lot, but you also get EMP'd. So you need to make sure that you stay away from that thing and target your fire away. And we managed to take it down very, very quickly using homing grenades, a mix of the AI assault drone, and just our weapons as well to take it out. But I can imagine this being a very, very hard boss to fight against later on into the rounds, as it just makes such a commotion, and its presence on the map just makes everyone very, very scared. But if you do manage to take it out, you do get rewarded with a max ammo, which is always great. Really, really helpful, because you've just literally wasted all your ammo trying to kill that thing. But another really weird, cool little addition to this map is that there are rounds where the infected round is taken into a kind of new twist of a way. So essentially, areas of the map will be completely locked off, and these manhole covers will start pouring out acid gas. And what happens is, if you're trapped within that area where the gas is, you can't leave the area, or you can't enter a new area, so you have to stay there for the entire round. So it makes it a little bit tricky, and it really beefs up the difficulty a little bit. This map is a lot more difficult than the previous map, simply because there's such a lot of things to be constantly thinking about, with the whole gas zombie, the fact you've got to protect the civilians. If you don't do that, you're going to get punished in some sort of way. You also have the Goliath zombie as well. It's just a lot of things to think about. And those toxic zone rounds last for a entire round, so if you walk into that, you become infected and you have to make your way to the infected pad. And rather than in the first map where it's pretty easy to access it, the map is a lot bigger and it does take you quite a bit of time to actually get to the pad to cure yourself of the infection. But that's all I have for the map commentary wise. Bear in mind, the gameplay is taken from two games, and that was the only two games I've played on this map, so of course I'll be getting more in depth with this map over the next week when the DLC comes out. So make sure to check my channel for that, subscribe for all the latest exo zombie goodness. I've also got some videos up, or will be up shortly, looking at the new microwave gun, and also we'll be having the cutscene, which will be of course released when the map comes out. So I have all that goodness. I'll be doing a live stream of the exo zombies map, trying to go for a decent high round. We'll have Easter egg guides, we'll have Easter egg parts, we'll have live commentaries, challenges on the map, just a load of stuff. So if you're into all that stuff, make sure to subscribe to the channel so you don't miss out on that great content. Like I said at the start, if you enjoyed the video, smash a like rating down below. I'd really, really appreciate that. And I will be giving away some codes for this over the next week or so on my Twitter, so make sure to check my Twitter linked in the description. I'm going to leave you guys to watch the rest of the gameplay without my commentary, so enjoy, and I'll hopefully see you guys in the next one.
Lock and load! Come on.